subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Less than 2 weeks are left for the counting day in Delhi and election results, and the heat is really on. And what kind of heat? We saw something in Delhi that is unprecedented. Delhi otherwise is quite a safe place, but we saw this incredible spectacle of one person like a lone wolf sort of running, shouting and screaming with a pistol, with a country-made pistol, shooting at people in Shaheen Bagh, Jamia Millia area, and basically crying death to the quote-unquote traitors. And just before coming, he had also put something on his Facebook page saying that this was going to be the end of Shaheen Bagh. So what is it, and we'll talk about this before we conclude, but what is it that is causing this kind of desperation in Delhi? This attack was obviously a result of the dog whistling that's been going on for some time. Remember, we keep explaining to you what dog whistling is. It's like when you have a dog and set the dog upon somebody and say shh, shh, like that. That is dog whistling. So that's been going on, and somebody, I'm not calling him a dog, it's an idiom. Somebody picked up a pistol and tried to shoot people, and one man was hurt. Fortunately, it seems not very grievously. Now, the question is, why is Delhi such a desperate battle for the BJP that it has upped the temperature to this level? This is the most heated campaign Delhi has seen in decades. What is at stake? And in fairness, you have to say that most of the heat has been turned on by the BJP. It's the BJP's campaign that's divisive, bordering on the abusive, sometimes getting to abusive. If you say, Desh ke gaddaron ko goli maro, maro salon ko, it is abusive. It's not just abusive, it's an instigation for murder and rioting, and some of that may have happened today. So what is this desperation? Why is Delhi such a big prize? After all, Delhi sends only 7 MPs to national parliament. That is a half of Jharkhand. Half of Jharkhand or a half of Assam, much less than Haryana. So what is the big deal about Delhi? Also, the way Delhi is structured, Delhi is not a full-fledged state. Delhi's chief minister has very limited powers. The part of Delhi that really matters to central India, that is Latians Delhi, all of it is controlled directly by NDMC, which is fully under central government's control. State government has nothing to do with it. Then the two other big powers that chief ministers have in the Indian system, over land and over the police, law and order, Delhi chief minister does not have those. Those rest fully with the central government. Even the powers that the chief minister has in the areas that the chief minister exercises power or the elected government exercises powers, LG of Delhi, lieutenant governor, has a strong oversight role. So LG of Delhi is not like any titular governor of any classical state in India. So this is a very truncated state. It's not even half a state in terms of the powers of the elected government. So what's the big deal? And if it sends 7 MPs to Lok Sabha, BJP has those 7 anyway. It won those 7 just 7 months back. And the next election is more than 4 years away. So why such desperation about this little one-third of a state? Little state by itself and a state government which has only one-third of the powers of any other state government. So I will try and explain some of that to you, looking at the facts. So first of all, look at the big picture. Every election is about the big picture. Sometimes even one by-election can be as important as a full general election. I'll take you back to 1988. VP Singh had just resigned from Rajiv Gandhi's cabinet, protesting over Bofors. He resigned his parliament seat and went back to contest the by-election from Allahabad. Allahabad seat, if you remember, had been vacated because Amitabh Bachchan had resigned from Lok Sabha. So he went to contest the by-election there, and that became a big referendum on VP Singh versus Rajiv Gandhi. And then Congress party threw everything in there. And the question was, point was, if VP Singh wins here, despite the might of Congress party, then his sitara or star will be up. So these are bellwether elections. Look at the trend in Indian politics since May of 2019. That was 7 months back when the general elections took place. Three state elections have taken place after that. Delhi will be the fourth. Which three have taken place? That is Maharashtra. Maharashtra is the second biggest state in India after UP in terms of its contribution to Lok Sabha. Maharashtra, Haryana, and Jharkhand. Now, what has happened in each one? And again, we will give you the context. So, August 5 is when all the big changes are carried out in Kashmir, Article 370, etc. So, you are expecting now that this is really going to repeat the sweep of a couple of months earlier for the BJP in both the states, that is Haryana and Maharashtra, which have a strong nationalist element, lots of connect with the armed forces, and which had just voted Narendra Modi big time. Now, those two states, look at the numbers. In Haryana, in May, BJP had got 59% seats. In Maharashtra, BJP had got, again in May, BJP, which Shiv Sena, its ally, had got 51% vote, sorry, not seats. So, 51 and 59. Now, you thought Article 370. And then the Supreme Court order on the temple came and everybody said, ab Gagan Chumbi Mandir Banega, temple kissing the skies, etc., etc. So, this was a deadly combination. This was popularity of Narendra Modi, the momentum of Lok Sabha victory, and now this double blow of, or sort of the double engine of Article 370, Kashmir changes, and also the temple. And you thought, the BJP would have thought that we are going to sweep these elections. And that was the calculation. Remember in Haryana, they had said, Abki bar, 75 par, 75 out of 90. And what happened? In Haryana, the BJP fell short. In Maharashtra, the BJP with its ally Shiv Sena had the seats, but not really enough by itself to swing the issue. So, Shiv Sena felt tempted to go away. BJP lost Maharashtra. In Haryana, it ended up sharing power with another ally. But what happened to its vote share? That's the important thing. So, in Maharashtra, its vote share from 51% with the ally came down to 42%. 9% is a very big loss. 9 percentage points, not 9% over the base. 51 to 42. That was bad enough in spite of Article 370, in spite of the temple. And in Haryana, something more remarkable happened. In Haryana, it came down from 59% to almost 36%. That is 23 percentage points. That's more than, they lost more than one third of their vote share from just 3 months earlier. That told the BJP that hawa has changed, or more than that, people might vote for Narendra Modi at the center, but on his call, they are no longer willing to vote for anybody else. So, he can't hold lamppost elections, and also that people are not so swayed by Article 370 and the temple. Then what happened? Then the third election took place, which was Jharkhand. Now, by the time Jharkhand happened, CAA also happened. Not fully, I think after a couple of phases in Jharkhand. But when CAA happened, protests happened, BJP leaders made the full use of it. Amit Shah said many things, other leaders said many things, and the Prime Minister, you'd remember, made that really avoidable remark where he said, look at who's rioting and who's protesting against CAA. You can tell from their clothes, from the clothes they are wearing, who's protesting. So, that was a strong enough signal for polarization. Did it work? You know the results. BJP lost that state. They had that state earlier. They were comfortable in that state. They had not dominated that state, but they were comfortable. But they lost that state, and you want to see the vote percentage. In parliament elections 2019, BJP had got 51.61% of the vote. In Vidhan Sabha elections, just 4 months after that, 4-5 months after that, they were 33.37%. So that's a loss of nearly 17 percentage points. I underline that fact again. That is, they lost again now one third of the vote share. In Haryana, they lost a little over one third of the vote share. In Maharashtra, they lost about 20% of their vote share. in Jharkhand, they again lost. So Jharkhand now, if Haryana and Kashmir and Haryana and Maharashtra vote share came down so substantially in spite of Article 370 and the temple, in Jharkhand it came down this much in spite of Article 370 and the temple and CAA midway through this election. So once again, two points were proved. One, that people who were willing to vote for Narendra Modi as Prime Minister were not willing to follow his call and vote for just anybody. So he was no Indira Gandhi of the 70s. And second, that people of India had now matured and they made different voting decisions for the national election and Vidhan Sabha election. So if they follow the same pattern in Delhi, what will happen? If the same pattern is now followed in Delhi, an Aam Aadmi Party comes back with big numbers, so sizable numbers, or with a clear victory. One, it will be a fourth setback for the BJP, all within 7-8 months of parliament victory, Lok Sabha sweep. It's a big, it doesn't feel good if you are a BJP supporter. Number two, it gives a second life to the legend of Arvind Kejriwal, who, as we had noted earlier, has set up the most successful startup in India's politics in the past decade. His is a non-ideological party. It is not based on any caste group, ethnicity, religion. So he has the potential to grow and then eat into Congress party's vote elsewhere. So he becomes a challenger. And third, other parties learn the lesson that look like the Congress party, and I will come to that, that maybe it's a better strategy to choose whoever has the best chance of defeating Narendra Modi and let them do it. So Congress party, if you walk around Delhi, you will find Congress party is missing in action, MIA. They put up candidates, there's hardly any campaigning. In fact, as I speak today, Rahul Gandhi is doing something in Wayanad. They put up a few hoardings here and there, but beyond that, you can see that this looks like Congress party offering a friendly fight to the Aam Aadmi Party. Intention is quite clear. Don't take away any of the votes that would have gone to Aam Aadmi Party, because that would then help the BJP. BJP's big chance in Delhi is Congress party getting a lot of votes. So this is, everybody's stakes are high, Congress's stakes are high, and for the BJP, this makes it more complicated for them, because if this works, then other parties will start doing this in other states and Congress will start doing it in other states. Now, there are other issues. One, as we told you, Delhi is the final test of this 370 plus temple plus CAA, which equals nationalism plus anti-Pakistanism plus jingoism plus blah, blah, blah. At a time when economic indicators are so bad, you cannot go to the elections on the basis of your performance. But next, it is important for the BJP to somehow do better in Delhi to protect the Modi brand. And you can see it in the way BJP is structuring this campaign. You see very little of Narendra Modi in this campaign. So far, we have seen only one rally from him, and that was before the campaign had formally begun. That was at Ramlila ground. After the campaign formally began, he has not held a rally in Delhi as yet. For the first time, BJP has put Amit Shah up front. So Amit Shah is the face of the campaign. In fact, if you see BJP's advertisements in newspapers also, very many of them just have Amit Shah's picture in them. So there is an effort to protect Narendra Modi, not let it become Modi versus Kejriwal. To that extent, I would go to the extent of saying that the BJP is blinking. It's a little battle shy, but having done that, it's trying its best, or however you define the best, to win Delhi, because they have to protect brand Modi. Next, it's a very big test for Amit Shah. One, it's the first election that he's leading up front with Modi in the back. He has to prove that he can win an election as well. He's proved himself to be a great strategist, but so far as a mass leader, as somebody who can go and swing votes, who can win elections, he hasn't done it. So, you know, I keep straying into cricket all the time, but it's a bit like, why leave all the scoring to Virat Kohli? So Mr. Rohit Sharma also arrives. So it's Amit Shah's opportunity to show that if Narendra Modi is Virat Kohli, he's Rohit Sharma. He can also score and he can also win the match for his team. Also, the election is being set around an agenda which has been devised by Amit Shah. That is Article 370, Temple, CAA, particularly Article 370 and CAA, because both have come from his ministry and he has fronted both of them and backed both of them. So I would go to the extent of saying that 2020 is to Amit Shah what 2002 was to Narendra Modi, which means 2002 was after the riots, and everybody knew that if Narendra Modi wins again after the riots, then he will rise as a national leader. So 2020 for Amit Shah is exactly the same way. And he's not exactly the same age as Modi was in 2002, but about that age. So it's a very interesting situation for Amit Shah, because at some point there will be talk of his successor. He has to prove himself in Delhi. So these are the various things which make this Delhi tiny states, tiny non-states or quasi-states election so bitter. And that's what led today to this incident in Delhi. And once again, I use the expression dog whistling. This is really a question of, there's a biblical reference, biblical saying that we use in English language. If you sow the wind, you will reap whirlwind. You can translate this into Hindi. Jaisa boge, vaisa kaatoge, or more colorfully, you can say, boya ped babool ka to aam kahan se khaye. That, you know, if you grow a babool tree, you can't pluck mangoes from it. So this is something that the BJP and the BJP's campaigners have started. Two have been banned from campaigning by the Election Commission. But really, it is unfortunate for a city as cosmopolitan as Delhi to be dealing with a campaign as divisive as this. But then, as we have said again and again and again, all is fair in love, war and elections. And this is a desperate election for the BJP for all the reasons we have listed for you already.